Dear students, from the last class, we are discussing about restriction enzymes. Naming of restriction enzymes based on some principles and some types of restriction in examples of restriction enzymes we have discussed. In this class, let us discuss about the classification of restriction enzymes and about sticky ends. And first we will discuss about restriction enzymes classification. That means restriction enzymes belongs to a large class of enzymes called nucleases. Restriction enzymes belongs to the large class of enzymes that is called nucleases. There are two kinds of nucleases. There are two kinds or there are two types of nucleases. One is exonucleases and another one is endonucleases. There are two types of nucleases. One is exonucleases and another one is endonucleases. Exonucleases are the enzymes or nucleases which remove the nucleotides from the ends of the DNA. For example, this is a DNA. This is a DNA. Exonucleases remove the nucleotides which are present at the ends. Which are present at the ends means this end or this end. 3' end or 5' end. Restriction endonucleases remove the nucleotides which are present at the ends, either at the 3' end or at the 5' end. Like that, they remove the nucleotides. Hence, they are called as exo. Exo means outside. Or they remove the nucleotides from the sides or from the ends. Whereas, endonucleases, endo means inside, which remove the nucleotides at specific position within the DNA. Endonucleases remove the nucleotides or they cut the DNA at specific location within the DNA. Means they cut the DNA at the center or near the center like that. But exonucleases cut the DNA at the ends or they remove the nucleotides which are present at the ends of the DNA. But endonucleases cut the DNA or they remove the nucleotides at a specific position within the DNA. All restriction endonucleases have specific recognition sequence within the DNA molecule. All the restriction endonucleases have specific recognition sequence within the DNA molecule. At that specific recognition sequence only, they cut the DNA. Specific recognition sequences are about 4 to 6 base pairs long. Specific recognition sequences are about 4 to 6 base pairs long. 4 to 6 base pairs long means, for example, this is a DNA. This is a DNA. 4 to 6 adenine, this is one base pair, then this is another base pair, one more base pair, like this. Like this. This recognition sequences of restriction endonucleases are about 4 to 6 base pairs. Means consider this is the region which is the recognition sequence for particular restriction endonuclease. And each restriction endonuclease recognizes a specific palindromic nucleotide sequences in the DNA. All restriction endonuclease enzymes recognize the specific palindromic sequences. Palindromic sequences or palindromic nucleotide sequences present in the DNA. See, this is the 4 to 6 base pair length of recognition sequences for restriction endonucleases. And always the recognition sequences are the palindromic nucleotides. They are the palindromic nucleotide sequences. Palindromic nucleotide sequences means two strands in this region are identical. The two strands of the DNA in that particular region are identical when read both in forward as well as in backward directions. For example, Example for palindromic sequences, nucleotide sequences. Example, madam, M-A-D-A-M, madam. Then Malayalam. See, these two are the palindromic sequences. See, if you read this word in forward or backward direction, you will read the same. Palindromic sequences means these are the sequences present in the particular region are identical when read in both forward as well as in backward directions. See, if you read this word in this direction, forward direction, then madam. If you read the same word in backward direction, then also you will read the same, madam. Malayalam. Right? Like this, palindromic nucleotide sequences are present in the DNA at specific region or at the specific point. Such palindromic sequences will be recognized by the restriction endonucleases. First, these restriction endonucleases enzymes inspect the length of the DNA sequences. First they will read or they first they will inspecting the length of the DNA sequences. Then once restriction endonuclease finds its specific recognition sequence, once it finds its specific recognition sequence, then restriction endonuclease will bind to the DNA and they cut each of the two strands of the DNA at a specific site, in their sugar phosphate backbones in such a way that DNA come to possess a short single-stranded free ends called sticky ends. First, before cutting the DNA molecule, restriction endonuclease enzyme inspect the length of the DNA. First, it observes the complete DNA molecule. Then, it find out the specific recognition sequence present in the DNA or the point where that recognition sequence is present in the DNA. After recognizing the palindromic sequences present in the DNA, restriction endonuclease enzyme binds to the DNA, binds or it attaches to the DNA. Then restriction endonuclease enzyme cut each of the two strands of DNA at specific points in their sugar phosphate backbones. First, it recognizes the palindromic sequence or recognition sequences present in the DNA. Then enzyme binds to the DNA. After that, it cut each of the two strands of the DNA. Means it will cut both the strands of the DNA in their sugar phosphate backbones in such a way that DNA come to possess short, single-stranded free ends called sticky ends. Means, for example, consider this DNA molecule having specific recognition sequence. First, restriction endonuclease recognize the DNA molecule. After recognizing the DNA molecule, it recognizes the recognition sequences or palindromic sequences present in the DNA molecule. After that, enzyme restriction endonuclease cut the DNA in such a way that it should possess sticky ends. Means, this is one strand of the DNA and this is the another strand of the DNA. Like this, it cuts the DNA. See, these are sticky ends. This is sticky end. This is also a sticky end. So, sticky ends are nothing but short, single-stranded free ends. It's a short, single-stranded free end. Here also, sticky end. Short, single-stranded free ends are called as sticky ends. For example, restriction endonuclease EcoR1. Restriction endonuclease EcoR1, which is isolated from the bacteria E. coli or Escherichia coli. The restriction endonuclease EcoR1, Escherichia coli, EcoR1 recognizes the base sequences. It recognizes the base sequences G, A, A, T, T, C. The recognition sequences for EcoR1 is G, A, A, T, T, C. G, A, A, T, T, C. Here, C, T, T, A, A, G. This is the recognition sequence for the restriction endonuclease EcoR1. See, this is the palindromic sequence, palindromic nucleotide sequence present in the DNA. If you read this palindromic sequence in the forward direction, then you will read it as GAATTC. If you read the same sequence, if you read the sequence in the backward direction, then also you will read GAATTC. This is the palindromic nucleotide sequence for EcoR1. And this is very, very important. The palindromic sequence for EcoR1, restriction endonuclease, EcoR1 is GAATTC. And this EcoR1, Escherichia coli R1, cuts the DNA strands between G and A. It cuts the DNA strand between G and A, means EcoR1, restriction endonuclease 1. EcoR1, Escherichia coli R1, this cuts the DNA between G and A, means like this. Between G and A, it cuts the DNA. So, after cutting that, we'll get the DNA sequences. Here only G will be remaining in this strand. C, T, T, A, A will be remaining, and A, A, T, T, C, and here only G. See, this is called sticky end. These two are the sticky ends. Like this. Restriction endonuclease EcoR1 cuts the DNA at specific site. See, this is the sticky end. short, short, single stranded, short, single stranded, free ends. Short, single stranded, free ends are called as sticky ends. Like this, sticky ends are produced by the restriction endonucleus ECOR1. The single stranded free ends of the DNA can join with similar complementary ends of the DNA fragments when DNA double helix is subjected to ECOR1. Such ends are called sticky ends. The single stranded free ends. See, this is the single stranded. Here it is, this region is not having the complementary strand. Here only C is having complementary base pair G. For TTAA, there is no complementary base pairs. That means this is the single stranded one. Here C is having the complementary base pair G. The remaining TTAA is not having complementary base pairs here. So this TTAA, here AATT, these are single stranded free ends of the DNA. When these single stranded free ends of the DNA join with similar complementary ends of DNA fragments, when DNA double helix is subjected to ECOR1, then such ends are called as sticky ends. These single stranded free ends of the DNA can join with the similar complementary ends. Complementary ends means here AATT. This region can form complementary base pairing with AATT. Here TTAA. Means sticky ends or the free single stranded free ends of the DNA can join with the similar complementary ends of the DNA fragments when DNA double helix is subjected to ECOR1, then such ends are called as sticky ends. Means this sticky end should be able to form complementary base pairing with suitable base pairs. Means this region forms complementary base pairing with AATT. This one forms complementary base pairing with TTAA. Such ends are called as sticky ends. And what are sticky ends? What are palindromic sequence? Then the recognition sequence for ECO restriction endonuclease, ECOR1. These concepts are important in this topic. Here, in this case, say DNA is having two strands. One is directing towards 5' to 3', and the one is 3' to 5'. The palindromic nucleotide sequence for ECOR1: G, A, A, T, T, C. And here it is G, A, A, T, T, C is the palindromic nucleotide sequence for ECOR1. When you read the sequences from 5' to 3', you will read it as G, A, A, T, T, C. When you read the sequences from 5' to 3', then you will read it as G, A, A, T, T, C. That means you will read the same in both the direction, 5' to 3', or from 3' to 5'. Hence, these are called as palindromic nucleotide sequences. Here, ECOR1, restriction enzyme ECOR1, cut the DNA strand a little away from the center of the palindromic sides, but between the same two bases on the opposite strand. Say, here ECOR1 cuts the DNA between G and A. Here also it will cut the DNA between G and A, like this. This leaves single-stranded portion at the ends. Cutting off these sequences between G and A leaves small single-stranded portion at the ends. They are called as sticky ends. Why they are called as sticky ends means, because these sticky ends form hydrogen bonds with their complementary base cut counterparts. When this region, sticky ends, comes closer to the DNA sequences having complementary base pair, then they'll bind to them. Hence, they are called as sticky ends. These sticky ends facilitates the action of DNA ligase enzyme. That means, by the help of sticky ends, because of the presence of sticky ends, DNA ligase enzyme join the DNA molecules. This is about restriction endonucleases. This is the main enzyme which is required in rDNA technology or genetic engineering. Then another enzyme called DNA ligase. DNA ligase is a joining enzyme which is obtained from E. coli. DNA ligase. In DNA replication only we have discussed about DNA ligase. In case of DNA replication, DNA ligase enzyme is used to join the Okazaki fragments. Here, DNA ligase enzymes are commonly called as molecular stitchers. They are commonly called as molecular stitchers. DNA ligase are commonly called as molecular stitchers because they join the two cut ends of the DNA. DNA ligase join the two cut ends of the DNA. And this DNA ligase is used to join the gene of our interest to the DNA of the vector with its sticky ends. See, this is the gene of our interest. Gene of our interest, and this is the DNA of the vector. Gene of our interest, and this is the DNA of the vector. The joining of DNA of our interest with the DNA vector is facilitated by the enzyme DNA ligase, or this enzyme helps in binding of DNA of our interest with the DNA of the vector. Vector means it's a vehicle which transport gene of our interest to the particular bacterial cell or to the body of an organism or plant. About vector we are going to discuss in later classes. One more enzyme which is involved in genetic engineering is polymerase enzyme. Polymerase enzyme or synthesizing enzyme. These enzymes are used to synthesize new strands of DNA which is complementary to existing DNA or mRNA template. Already we have discussed about the function of polymerase enzyme. It helps in the synthesis of new DNA strands, which is new DNA strand which is complementary to the existing DNA or mRNA template. DNA polymerases and reverse transcriptases are two polymerase enzymes. One is DNA polymerase enzyme and another one is reverse transcriptase. Both are required for the synthesis of DNA strand. Reverse transcriptase is the enzyme which synthesizes the DNA from mRNA. DNA polymerase enzyme is helpful for the synthesis of new strands of DNA using DNA template. DNA polymerases helps in the synthesis of complementary strands of the DNA on template DNA. Reverse transcriptase enzyme helps in the synthesis of complementary DNA strands on mRNA templates. So this is about restriction endonuclease enzyme, DNA ligase and polymerase enzyme. In the next class, we will discuss about mechanism of production of rDNA or recombinant DNA. Thank you.